Welcome to a new video. Yesterday I set up my block behind a hidden service in the Tor network, and today I will try to get my reverse shell from the last video running inside the Tor network. I set up my Tor on my Raspberry Pi. Let me just check if the Tor service is running. So this works fine, and the other is at default. This works also fine, and quit. Can I open a This is on my Raspberry Pi, where I set up the hidden service, and this is on my local device. And now the goal is to config the hidden service to use my reverse shell. But in the first step, I will use the SSH service I have already run on my Raspberry Pi, so I don't have to. This is the first step to figure out how this works. I think it would not be complicated to set up the hidden service. I think it's more complicated to use the Tor service on my local device. So I think what was this is the config file where I config my hidden service, and this example down there shows already what we want to do. So we want to have port 22 on my local 22, and I think that was it. So restart the service, I guess, and then check if it's running correctly. Yeah, you see down there bootstrap 0%, but no error, so this work should run. I will show you the hidden service I have already set up. This is the Tor browser, and cat lib tor, and there it is. This is my hidden service, and pass this in, and I hope, yes, you came to my blog page. So everything works fine. The hidden service are running. Now it's time to figure out how we can use the secure shell on my local device to connect to my server. So that sounds really easy. I find a Torify, a program that's check on your system if there's Tor running, and use the best way to connect to the Tor network, I guess. So the service should start. We can check also if this command kit, and with default, yeah, it's running. Everything works fine on my local device. It's simple Torify SSH, I guess, add. I may have no. Copy my servers and try it. Yes, of course. And boom, there I am. Okay, maybe this is too simple. but okay. So, the secure shell works quite easy. So, what is the next step? The next step is to run my reverse shell. So, I have to set up the port. Restart tool. I want to, I think, git install. Yes, git is install on my server. Then I want to GitHub. Want to clone my repository where I have a reverse shell. So there are the two files, and on my server I run the server script. And on my target device, I change to my enter the host name. I'm not sure if it's working. Yes, I get the answer string, and on my listening to my if I minus A. Yeah, it's my dragon, it's my target device. It's also really simple. Let me quick sum this up. So I simple have installed the have installed Tor on both devices, on my server and on my target device. And if I install Tor under Linux, the command torify will be also installed, and with torify I can simply tunnel my connection to the Tor network, and then I can enter domain names from the origin network. And on the server to create a hidden target, I simply have to change the config, and this will enable the hidden service. Yeah, I think it's make it really simple to tunnel my all the traffic through the Tor network. This was everything I want to try. It go much faster than I accept. So, hope you like the video. Please like and subscribe, and we will see you next time. I'm not sure what I will have done there, but hopefully something interesting.